Major issue underway on Capitol Hill, high-stake budgets talks unfolding as lawmakers clash on how to tackle $14 trillion in debt. Now, the debate is now making its way into the ads that you see on TV every single night. So here's the question, how are Americans responding to it? Frank Luntz is a pollster and author of Win, The Key Principles to Take You from Ordinary to Extraordinary. You know, Frank, when you look at any of these polls, people say that they care about jobs and the economy first and foremost, but you're seeing some ads on the debt. How's that going over with voters so far?
Well, it depends on how they do it. And there are three basic rules to advertising. Number one, you got to catch them in the first 5 seconds. If you don't, they'll turn the channel. Number two, it's got to be compelling, convincing, the C words, and credibility. And number three, the ending. Does it give you something that you will remember going forward? The first set I want to show you did very well. It comes from the Republican National Committee. Partisan ad. And yet you're going to see how well Democrats dial it up. The higher the lines climb, the more favorable the reaction. Red line are Republicans, blue line are Democrats. Let's take a look.
It's time Washington acted as responsibly as our families do. And on Monday, I'm proposing a new budget that will help us live within our means while investing in our future.
So does President Obama's budget live within our means? It's hard to see how. Obama's budget will run a $1.4 trillion deficit this year alone. And through 2021, his vision for winning the future includes $9.5 trillion in budget-busting deficits that lock in historic rates of big government spending. USA Today said of Obama's budget, it's becoming hard not to conclude that Obama doesn't much care about the debt threat. And rather than leading, the Washington Post said, President Obama's budget kicks the hard choices further down the road.
My hope is that what's different this time is we have an adult conversation where everybody says, here's what's important and here's how we're going to pay for it.
That conversation should start by acknowledging that we can't keep spending money we don't have.
So Frank, all this talk about the deficit is resonating with voters.
That last phrase, we can't spend money we don't have, that's the perfect ending to an ad that's got a lot of facts, a lot of figures, a little bit long for people, but very effective.
And it resonates with the left as well as the right. What about independents? I bet they love that one as well.
Independents even more so, because them, it's a Republican issue, it's a Democratic issue, it's an American issue, stop spending.
Okay.
Now you've got another ad there on Medicare, and this one is very polarizing, very divisive, but that's because the visuals are meant to be striking. Let's take a look.
This public service announcement is for anyone who will ever be 65 or older. Monday, word leaked of a plot to steal one of your most valuable assets, your Medicare. The thieves have been identified as insurance companies, desperate to get at the Medicare Trust Fund. They are abetted by Republicans whose budget replaces Medicare with a voucher to buy private insurance. The same Republicans who refuse to end tax breaks for millionaires want to put you at the mercy of the big insurance companies. If you know the whereabouts of these Republicans, call them. Tell them, hands off my Medicare.
All right, well, this one's certainly a lot harsher. Many would say that that's a scare tactic one. But as you point out, that seems to be working, in particular with Democrats.
It's only working, and even there, it doesn't even cross the 50 line. The fact is that the ad against Obama's budget does better among Democrats than the ads against the Republicans and Medicare. So you know that it's not effective. And the goal in these is to transcend politics, to transcend ideology. The visuals turn people off. The voice turned people off, that negativity, that threatening. This is an ad that fails. And I'll tell you something. We're testing them now. About 10% of the ads that you see are successful. About 50% of them don't move a single voter.
Mm-hmm. Frank, how has this changed since the last presidential election?
Good question. It's been much more dramatic. The visuals are much more powerful. But also the people who are producing the ads realize that they need to have facts, figures, statistics. They need to have evidence if they're going to make the claims stick.
All right, Frank Luntz, thank you so much. Always fascinating, isn't it? You know, we're going to be seeing so many more of these ads as we get a lot closer to the next.